वेलकम वन एंड ऑल, आई एम धनंजय पिसाई, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग साइंसेस, AISSMS, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, पुणे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ लेथ मशीन. Basically, machine tools are used for metal cutting operations and surface finishing operations. It is a power-driven tool used for making the desired shape of the component and required size and shape and surface finish by material removal process. It uses a cutting tool for removing the material from the workpiece. The different types of machine tools are lathe machine, drilling machine, grinding machine, milling machine, likewise. So the basically machine tools are used for converting the raw material into the required desired finished product by removing the unwanted material from the workpiece. And these machine tools are used for carrying out these operations with the help of cutting tools. So lathe machine, it is a general purpose power driven machine tools used to produce the cylindrical workpieces. Almost all types of metal cutting operations can be performed on the lathe machine. That is why it is called as a mother of all machine tools. So here you can see the constructional diagram of the lathe machine tools. On the left hand side of the lathe machine, we have the headstock wherein power driven assembly is there. Next is the spindle on which chuck is there for mounting the workpiece. In between these, we have these purple colors, the lead screw on which the carriage, compound carriage, is mounted. It is having the cross slide for forward and backward movement, whereas for the left right movement is done on the lead screw. Onto this carriage, we have the tool holder wherein we can mount the different tools. On the right hand side of the lathe machine, we have the tailstock. Here you can see the tailstock. Bottom part is called as a weight, and it is the lathe machine is kept on the solid base of concrete so that it can absorb the vibrations and weight of the lathe machine. So we will see one by one the different parts of the lathe machine. So here the first one is the headstock, wherein power driven assembly is there for providing the circular motion for the spindle on which this chuck is mounted. Here you can see the three jaw chuck wherein the cylindrical workpiece is mounted, then tool post. Now the figure, it is of square tool post. That means on each side of the square you can mount one tool at a time. So four tools can be mounted on this square tool post and one tool can be used for carrying out the operation at a time. Then this is tailstock. This one is a carriage. So with the help of these circular wheels, you can give the forward and backward movement for the tool post. Whereas with this bigger circular wheel, you can have the left and right movement along the lead screw of the carriage. This one is a lathe bed and these two are the guideways along which this carriage is mounted. This side Left hand side of the lathe machine is also called as a live center, whereas right hand side is called as a dead center, because here at the chuck side we are carrying out the operation of removing the material from the raw workpiece. So that is why it is called as a live center, whereas tailstock or dead center is used only for the holding purpose, that may be for holding long shafts between these two points, or it can be tailstock can be used for mounting of boring bar or drilling tool. Cutting tools which are used onto the lathe machine are called as a single point cutting tool or multi point cutting tool. So depends upon the point or number of points through which material is removed, it is classified as single point or multi point cutting tool. So here this one is the first one is the knurling tool, it is a multi point cutting tool. Second one is the drilling tool, it is again multi point cutting tool, whereas this one is the reamer, again it is a multi point cutting tool. And here you can see the tool holder with the inserts, these are called as the inserts, and these are the tool holders, black color tool holders. So these are called as a single point cutting tool. So with the help of single point cutting tool, so only one point is responsible for removing the material from the workpiece, whereas in the multi point cutting tools, the multi point or the through the multiple points material is removed from the workpiece. So it is called as multi point cutting tool, and this one is a single point cutting tool. The material which is used as a tool material, it is called as a high speed steel. Then the operations performed on the lathe machine. So first one is the turning operation. Turning operation is used for reducing the diameter of the workpiece. That means suppose you are having the raw material of 30 mm diameter and your required size it is of 25 mm diameter. So we have to reduce the diameter from 30 mm to 25 mm. To reduce this diameter, we have to carry out the turning operation. So we'll use the single point cutting tool over here, and we'll provide the circular motion for the workpiece, and from this point we'll move towards the left hand side so that cylindrically the diameter or the extra material from the cylindrical workpiece will be removed and diameter will be reduced. So here you can see we have to move the tool along the workpiece parallel to the axis of the lathe machine so that it will reduce the diameter. So it is a turning operation. Second operation is the facing operation. Facing operation is used to reduce the length of the workpiece. So along the face of the workpiece we are removing the material. So feed will be perpendicular to the axis. Feed means the movement of tool along the workpiece. So it is perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece, so that here you can see the material will be removed from the face of the workpiece so that length of the workpiece can be reduced. Next one is the chamfering operation. It is used for removing the sharp corners of the workpiece. So here you can see the chamfer. So with the help of single point cutting tool you can carry out the chamfering operation. Just we have to tilt the tool post at an angle of chamfer, required chamfer. Generally it is of 45 degrees, so we have to tilt the tool post at 45 degrees Celsius 45 degree, and then we have to give the feed in perpendicular direction and along the axis of the workpiece. So simultaneously two feeds we have to give, and the left hand side feed will be very small. It is around 2 to 3 mm only. So it is chamfer so that we can remove the sharp corners from the workpiece. Next operation is the knurling operation. It is for producing the diamond type of surface finish onto the cylindrical workpiece. So two helical gears are there, and a knurling tool is used for carrying out this knurling operation so that it will produce a diamond type of surface finish. So here we have to give the feed in perpendicular as well as along the length of the workpiece so that it will trace or it will create the diamond type of surface finish along the workpiece. Next one is the parting off operation. It is for creating the parting onto the workpiece. So tool which is used for the parting off operation is the parting tool here. So here you can see the parting off of the workpiece. Next one is the grooving tool. Grooving operation to produce the groove of required shape. So you can produce the semicircular groove or square type of groove onto the workpiece with the help of grooving tool. So feed will be along the perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece. Next one is the threading operation. So threading tool will be used for producing the threads onto the workpiece. Feed will be along the length of the workpiece and towards the left hand side. Next operation is the drilling operation. So you can create the hole, circular hole along the axis of the workpiece with the help of drill. So we have to mount the drill onto the tailstock, and then we have to give the feed to the tailstock along the axis of the workpiece to create the hole inside the workpiece. So drilling, it is a creation of circular hole inside the workpiece. So here you can see the drilling operation. Next one is the reaming operation. It is for finishing the circular hole inside the workpiece. Taper turning operation to produce the taper along the workpiece length. So here again we have to give the feed in parallel as well as perpendicular direction of the axis. Next one is the boring operation. To enlarge the previously drilled hole, we have to carry out the boring operation. The tool which is used for the boring operation is called as a boring tool, and this tool is mounted on the tailstock of the lathe machine. So here you can see it. With the help of boring operation, we are enlarging the previously drilled hole. So it is a boring operation. Next one is the forming operation. For producing the shapes onto the workpiece, we have to carry out the forming operation. So shape of the tool will be same as that of the required shape onto the finished product. So this one is the forming operation. Again, the feed will be perpendicular and along the axis of the lathe machine. So these are the different operations which can be performed on the lathe machine. That is why it is called as a mother of all the machine tools. Thank you.